So in this video, I'm going to show how to set up an ePrint from IND360. IND360 cannot connect to any physical printers, but it can connect to your PC to do what we call an ePrint through Ethernet TCP IP. So the first thing we want to make sure is that your computer, whatever will be receiving the ePrint message, will be connected to that same service Ethernet port that you use to connect to the web server of IND360. The next thing we need to know is what port to talk to. So to find that, we're going to go to Communication and then Service. So we can see that ePrint is enabled, and we see that this ePrint port is 1025. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump over to YAT. This is also possible to do in other programs such as Hyperterminal, Hercules, or many others. I just happen to be using YAT because it's what I have available to me. But if I go into check my settings, I will see that I am a TCP IP client, which is correct. I use that web server IP address of IND360, and this is where we put in that 1025 port that we just saw in the web server. So everything looks okay to me, so I will select OK, and now I will open the connection to the terminal. And all I'm going to do on the front of the terminal is, when I'm ready for that ePrint, I'm going to do a short press of the ePrint button. So after a short press of the ePrint button, we see the date and time, we see the gross weight, the net weight, and the tear weight, and we get that all packaged into one message that comes across. That ePrint can be triggered from the front panel of the IND360, and it can also be triggered from a PLC command using the Standard Automation Interface Protocol, SAI. So it's as simple as that to do an ePrint from IND360. Again, just make sure you're using the web server port of the IND360 for that connection. So until next time, thank you.